I'm very glad to be here. AUC for me is a home. I was a student here. I taught here for many years. I have lots of colleagues and lots of smiling faces, so this is how I take my breath back. Okay, I'm at it. All right. I'll be talking about the public sector. In Egypt, the challenges and the opportunities, this is the title. Very briefly, I want to start by making three key comments or three key observations before I start. The first one is that it's acknowledged by everybody from the presidential office or department down, all the way down, that the private sector is the one that is leading the economic development of the country. No question about it. Let's be very clear and very blunt about that. That's the first thing. The second thing, when we talk about challenges and opportunities, and this is really the title with the public sector for this session, challenges translate into opportunities right away. So a challenge is an opportunity for somebody to do something to fix it. Okay? That's the second observation. The third observation is that when we talk about the public sector, okay, we really have to differentiate between a bunch of things. We cannot take it as a bulk. Public sector is a very big, broad title. One of them is, of course, the legacy of the public sector, as you have in mind, the public sector companies, particularly in manufacturers that we have around. That's one group. But you also have a legacy of a bunch of public institutions that are in charge and that guide or affect the performance of the private sector in the different parts of the economy. This is part of the public sector, the public institutions. Then you have the third part being the public sector in services as the third legacy, okay, like in transportation and so on. Okay? So these are three different parts. And they're all on the legacy side because they are inherited from a long time ago. Then you have what I do not want to call the new public sector, but let's call it the new role of the public sector, which is actually seen in new involvement of the government in activities, in productive activities, new role by the army that everybody is also observing. These are all the different components of the formula. So when we talk about the public sector, we have to talk about all of these, okay? And as I talk about each one of them very briefly within the allocated time, which Gihad gave me as 12 minutes, well, 13 minutes and 15 seconds, something that specific, okay? Let me start by the from the easier to the tougher, okay? Let me start by what I call the new role of the public sector, okay? We are observing a lot of activities by the government, okay? Lots of investment by the government in a broad sense, army included, in certain productive sectors. Okay? This was done because we started an economic reform program, and along with this reform program, we were pushing on the development side, okay, with big projects. And it's very tough to do these two together, to reform the economy and at the same time try to push things forward, try to create jobs as temporary as they are in certain projects, okay? But it's not very easy. And with a government that is on the weak side, with institutions that need a lot of reform and a lot of improvement, the army was used as the vehicle, actually, to try and push these things forward. Of course, initiating projects is one thing. Managing these projects and maintaining them for the future of the country is another story altogether. And so what is expected in the next phase and what is advised and expected and quite understood is that the army cannot continue to play this role. It will have to be the private sector that takes over after that. So then the role here, okay, is not a role of the government in a sustainable way or in a continuous and a permanent way, but rather a way of pushing, initiating things, sort of an incubator kind of thing, initiating projects that would be taken over and managed after that by the private sector because it's the only one that can do it. Okay, so this is this part of the public sector. We have the second part of the public sector being the public institutions, okay, that are in charge of many things. Like when you talk about the Ministry of Agriculture, when you talk about the Research Institute in Agriculture, when you talk about agriculture is always a very good example there because it's always seen as a private thing. Everybody owns land, agriculture is private, so what is there to talk about? No, it's not really completely private, because you have the cooperatives, you have the Ministry of Agriculture, you have the research institute within agriculture, et cetera, all of these need serious restructuring and serious improvement, because at this point they are impeding the development of the private sector. Okay, so part of handling the private sector, they need transformation, they need serious restructuring and improvement, so that they become an enabler for the private sector and not an impediment. We know that there are a lot of things that can be improved, but there is no time for this within the allocated time that the head allowed me. Again, then you have the public sector that's involved in services. Okay, in all countries in the world, you always have some involvement, okay, of the government in the area of services. Okay, because there is a bit of social justice, a bit of geographic justice that would not be necessarily achieved if you have the private sector that's completely in charge of this. For example, if you think of transportation, you would not have a train or a bus go to very, very far away places where there is only one individual that would come out on the bus. They would not do it normally, okay? But if the government is involved, then it would happen. And it has to happen because it's part of the country and this person is a citizen, okay? But the fact that the public institutions are involved in that does not mean it does not have to be efficient, okay? It has to be efficient, and it can have the private sector involved in the management with the rules of the government that maintain the geographic justice and the social justice part of it, so we would have efficiency and we would have fairness at the same time. But this also requires quite a bit of structural reform. Then we reach really the toughest part, okay, which is the legacy of the number of companies, a number of public sector companies that are in the manufacturing sector. And here we need to answer two questions, okay? What needs to be done if we're really doing it correctly? And what are the present efforts, and where do they fit in this correct picture? What needs to be done, first of all, we have to make sure that whatever solution that we reach has to be fair. You cannot punish workers who are working in the public sector because they are there, okay, and they are excess and they are not needed. They did not employ themselves, they did not appoint themselves. You did, as a government, as a country. So whatever solution you talk about has to be fair. Whatever solution you talk about has to increase the efficiency of that sector, okay? It has to be associated with the value chain, the clear value chain approach, and with the purpose of being more efficient, not with the purpose of selling, I have to sell it, okay? It's give you an itch, it has to be sold. No, it has to look at the value chain, look at what can be done, okay? If it is useful at all, if it is not useful, then how to handle it in the right way. We have to look at innovative solutions for handling it, okay? Because it's quite sensitive area. And we have to be, most important of all, we have to be very, 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 from now until tomorrow, transparent about it. We cannot do it in hiding. We cannot do it in a blurred way. We cannot pretend that people do not see what's happening. So it has to be done in a very transparent way. This is how it should be done, okay? Now, what are we doing really about it, okay? And what can be proposed, okay? What we are doing really about it is sort of tackle the problem in a very, very careful way, but only scratching the surface, not really reaching a solution, okay? We are doing a bit of selling for some of the shares of these companies. The selling as it stands right now, 20% here, 15% there in the stock market, in my opinion, okay, is not going to do much, okay? Because here, what you are selling is not a percentage of the shares that would make a transformation in the management, okay? The management is associated with what's being, you know, who has the shares, all right? So you're not really doing that, okay? And it's not very clear what's gonna happen with the funds that are coming out of the sale. Are you going to take this money and re-inject it in the sector so that the areas that are good, okay, and can be better would be improved? Is this really what's going to happen? It's not very clear at this point. So in my opinion, this is not really the solution, okay? In my opinion, the solution should be to do an assessment of all those public sector companies, all those holding companies, not as a holding company, but rather as individual enterprises, those affiliated companies, assess them one by one, see which ones have economic feasibility, in other words, which ones are really needed, which ones really have value added, which ones really have a market share, and the issue is more or less associated with their management, okay, which is a big issue, and with the number of employees. But the factory itself is needed. Okay? If this is done at every sector, then you are going to end up selling some companies for sure because they are not needed. Okay? Okay. Now, as you sell them, what do you do? Okay? The funds have to be re-injected in the system so that the ones that are feasible can actually grow. You would have an improved technology. You would have better results. Okay? Now, what about the workers? Most of the workers that are in the public sector companies, from the initial assessments, okay, are all on the older side. In other words, we're talking about from 55 on, ones that are very close to the retirement age, okay? Which means that the handling here could be early retirement and a lot of other things, okay? Where would the funds come from? The funds should come from areas like the social fund. If you know the social fund, when the social fund was first created, one of its big objectives, okay, was to actually have a program. Most of the funds were supposed to go actually for the restructuring of the public sector, which never took place. But there has to be a fund that deals with the workers in an extremely fair way, and there are lots of other solutions that are known, okay, like encouraging the workers to start small enterprises around this big enterprise to support in certain things, retrain the workers, okay, retrain them, reintroduce new skills so that they can go and help in other areas, okay, and so on and so forth. But the funds that are coming are re-injected, okay, in what remains in this value chain to make it actually much stronger. And we do have examples of success stories there, and this is where I'm going to end my talk. There is a company that you all know the name of. It's called Biscomasr in the food industries. Biscomasr was one of the total utter failures in the food industries, okay? Complete failure, all right? It was completely restructured by an investment fund, as a matter of fact, completely restructured without losing jobs, okay? Rebranding of the company using the original name, improving the techniques, doing a lot of things. Okay, if it could be done here, it can be done for a lot others. So there are many, many ideas there. So it does not have to be a complete close down. It does not have to be a complete sale of assets. It does not have to be a complete kick out of workers. It does not have to be completely out. Okay, it has to be looked at in a transparent way and deciding what needs to remain and can remain and would add value to the economy and what needs to disappear with funds going in the correct direction. This is just very briefly what I wanted to say, considering that I arrived late and all of this, and the time constraint. Thank you.